Dear students, today we are going to discuss about Gestalt therapy. Now let me introduce you to this lesson. This lesson is about Gestalt therapy. The contents of this lesson include human nature, basic concepts, goals of counseling, therapeutic relationship and process, techniques, application and evaluation of therapy. The objectives of this lesson is to help you understand about the basic concepts in Gestalt therapy, to learn the human nature, goals and process of counseling in Gestalt therapy, and to study the therapeutic techniques, application and evaluation of the therapy. Let us know in detail about Gestalt therapy. Gestalt therapy was developed by Frederick Perls and his wife Laura in the 1940s. It is a unique pattern in which parts are integrated into a whole. Human beings have the capacity to grow, to develop, and to become the persons they are meant to be, that is, whole. Individuals can cope with life problems if they are fully aware of what is happening in and around them. Clients have the ability to respond to their environment and ask to talk about the experience in counseling sessions. A person functions as a whole rather than different entities such as mind, body and soul with thinking, feeling and action. Gestalt therapy rejects the dualities or cannot separate the person from the environment as well as from the interpersonal relations. A mature person lives in the present, in the here and now. The main idea of Gestalt psychology is that the whole is more than summation of the parts. For example, water is H2O, but we cannot study the gaseous components of hydrogen and oxygen to know about water. Likewise, an organism is a functional unit and the organism cannot be subdivided into different parts to understand the organism. Perls theorizes that all organisms have a self-actualization motive, which is an inherent drive toward growth and need satisfaction. Each person will have an internal organismic self-regulation which leads him or her to self-actualization. Awareness and relationships with oneself and others are the major emphasis of Gestalt psychology. The primary focus of this approach is the present, the here and now. The treatment is finished when the patient has achieved the basic requirements, a change in outlook, a technique of adequate self-expression and assimilation, and the ability to extend awareness to the verbal level. When the organism reaches the state of integration that facilitates its own development and the person can be safely left to themselves. Let us understand the concept of human nature. Gestalt psychology, rooted in existential philosophy and focuses on the holistic nature of mankind. The major constructs in Gestalt counseling includes mind and body, past and present, and individual and environment. Human beings' environment is the foreground and the unexpressed feelings or unfinished business of a person is the figure. So, a person needs to be dealt with the environment or context along with the unexpressed feelings. George and Christiani, Gibson, Robert L. and Michelle Marians H. list 8 assumptions about the nature of humans that act as the framework for Gestalt counseling. Let us look into the framework. Individuals are composite wholes made up of interrelated parts. None of these parts, body, emotions, thoughts, sensations, and perceptions, can be understood outside the context of the whole person. Individuals are also part of their own environment and cannot be understood apart from it. People choose how they respond to external stimuli and internal stimuli. They are actors, not reactors. People have the potential to be fully aware of all their sensations, thoughts, emotions, and perceptions. Individuals are capable of making choices because they are aware. Individuals have the capacity to govern their own lives effectively. People cannot experience the past and the future. They can experience only themselves in the present. People are neither basically good nor bad. Gestalt therapists conclude that individuals have the capacity for self-direction and the person must be encouraged to take the responsibility of his life and to experience the here and now. Let us understand the basic and crucial concepts of Gestalt therapy. Homeostasis. It is a tendency toward attaining a balance in any situation. Our life has a number of unmet needs and the person will always strive to correct the imbalances. Our needs include hunger, thirst, shelter, exercise, social events, and so on are various unfinished business and the person is confused about which need to be focused. When a person focuses on an irrelevant need, that leads to some problems within the life of a person. The next concept is unfinished business. It is same as the unexpressed feeling like resentment, rage, hatred, pain, grief, guilt, etc. and unmet needs such as physiological, psychological, and social, and so on. If the unfinished business is not expressed, they linger in the background and enter into the present and interfere with effective contact with oneself and others. The unexpressed feelings and unmet needs seek completion, and if it is not dealt properly, that will lead to self-defeating behavior or blockage. The impasse or stuck point is a situation of believing that one is unable to support oneself and thus seek external support. The next concept, awareness. Awareness itself is curative because it is an internal regulation. The awareness means knowledge about themselves and the environment, which leads an organism or person to growth, integration, and differentiated unity. The premise of Gestalt therapy is that each person has capacity to know about themselves and move towards growth. Polster and Polster, Richard Scharf identifies four types of awareness, such as awareness of sensations and actions, awareness of feelings, awareness of wants, and awareness of values and assessments. The individual is responsible for self-knowledge and self-acceptance and ultimately can make choices. Clients reach an impasse and they doubt about their ability and feel they need external support for their growth. The next concept is responsibility. Clients have the ability to respond to their environment appropriately and flexibly, which means a person is responsible or responsible. The client can discover the disowned part of self through conscious awareness that is considered and assimilated. If congruent, that is accepted and makes a part of the self and is rejected if the disowned self is incongruent. The process of re-owning and taking responsibility facilitates integration. The next concept is top dog versus underdog. This results from a faulty socialization process. During the process of socialization, many children are forced to follow the ideals and behavior that do not suit them. Top dog is often experienced as an over-righteous conscience, which attempts to control us by commanding, insisting, scolding, and demanding. Underdog acts as a passive resistance to deal with the shoots of top dog, which are inconsistent with the self-actualization motive. Next concept, here and now. The counselor and client form an alliance based on self-responsibility and an agreement to strive to be present with one another during their time together. The relationship is viewed as horizontal, and the therapist respects the client's capacity to heal and grow and willing to be an authentic person in the therapeutic relationship. Now, let us look into goals of counseling. The basic goal is to increase the awareness of the clients by providing a conducive environment to understand about themselves. Gestalt therapy affirms the human capacity for growth and healing through interpersonal contact and insight. The major objective is the integration of the person. Integration implies a person's feelings, perception, thoughts, and body processes are a part of a larger whole. The therapy helps the person to mature and grow up, and in turn makes him independent. Self-actualized, or being grounded in oneself, is the highest state a person can achieve. Tillett, Capuzzi, David Gross, and Douglas R. describe some of the goals as follows. First, developmental and expansion of physical and emotional awareness are emphasized. Intellectual insight and interpretation are limited. The relationship between the client and the counselor is existential as well as horizontal. Conversation between client and the counselor are useful only to the extent that they support enactment and experimentation. Change occurs as a result of heightened awareness of the interactional process between client and counselor. The gestalt therapist focuses on autonomy and growth of clients through increased awareness. The person should acquire micro-awareness, awareness of a particular content area, awareness of the awareness process. Through increased awareness, clients can discover available choices and alternatives that they may not have recognized due to limited self-awareness. Therapeutic relationship and process. In gestalt therapy, the interventions are focused on client-counselor relationship. For an effective gestalt therapy, a good therapeutic relationship is important. To bring about growth through awareness, a meaningful relationship is essential. I-though relationship, explained by Martin Buber, is important in gestalt therapy to explain dialogic relationship. A fully functioning I-though relationship need to be established to have a therapeutic change. The dialogue helps the people to understand each other and provides awareness. The empathic responding of the therapist provides continuing support to the client. After that, the clients need to support themselves through their motivation for therapy, intelligence, and commitment to therapy. Pearls believe that some people are unable to make progress because of the fear, what will happen? In such situations, the client reaches an impasse or stuck situation which need to be dealt. The gestalt therapist helps the patient to experience the blockage and to experiment with or fantasize about what will happen. This therapeutic change is possible with micro-awareness which have to provide through the therapy. Working through such an impasse is an important part of the change process in gestalt therapy. Miriam Polster has described a three-stage sequence of integration to enhance the change process. The first is discovery. In this stage, the client may get a new view about themselves and of the old situation. Second, accommodation. The patient learns that there are infinite choices and they can try out new behavior, and this learning requires therapeutic support from the counselor. Third, assimilation. The clients progress from choosing and trying out new behaviors from learning and how to make change in their environment. In the stage of assimilation, the clients can act assertively and get or make choices from their environment. Now let's study in depth about the techniques which we use in gestalt therapy process. First, empty chair dialogue. In this technique, an individual in fantasy puts the person with whom the client had unfinished business in an empty chair and engages in a dialogue. This dialogue method is a self-help technique through which one can let out the unexpressed feelings to a person. For example, if a client have unfinished business towards his superior, this technique may help to resolve the conflict. The internal polarities of the person, top dog versus underdog, also dealt through this technique, and client can accept and integrate both sides of the person themselves. I take responsibility. The clients are asked to end every statement about themselves with "I take responsibility for it." This may help to accept and recognize their feelings and take actions instead of projecting them onto others. The therapist has to facilitate the client. The third, reversals. In reversal, the clients are to act out the very opposite of the way they usually are in order to experience some hidden polarity of themselves. The client is asked to reverse a statement or a way of being. For example, if the client says, "I hate myself," that statement has to be reversed as, "I love myself." The next is dream work. The client is asked to reenact the dream in the present and to play out the parts of the dream as if the dream were happening in the here and now. Dream is a royal road to integration in gestalt psychology. Dreams are the metamorphic expressions of content and can reveal certain aspects of the person. The aspects of the self are brought into awareness of the client. Rehearsal. These exercises help the client to rehearse new sentences or actions that are different from his or her status quo. The clients have to say aloud what they are thinking silently to enhance their awareness. The next, non-verbal language. Skilled counselors listen to verbal communication along with non-verbal behavior. In addition to the words, the message behind the words, which is often conveyed in the voice tone, pitch, volume, and speed of delivery, are considered in this technique. The non-verbal behavior reveals the feeling of a person. Gestalt therapy is grounded on existential principles and is applicable to diverse client populations. Gestalt therapy pays attention to how clients view their world based on the figure ground, perception of a person. An individual is seen as ultimately healthy if that individual is striving for balance, health, and growth. The healthy person concentrates on one need at any present time and delegates other needs to the background. When the need is met, gestalt closes and is completed, and no business is left unfinished. When the need is unmet, the gestalt remains open and the person accumulates unfinished business. The quality therapeutic relationships are required for conducting this therapy, and the therapists are less likely to impose their own values and culture standards on their clients. Gestalt therapy can effectively use with children and adolescents, people with some oppression, and so on. Seligman, Capuzzi, David and Gross, Douglas R. stated that This therapy can be used successfully with the following disorders: mood, anxiety, somatoform, adjustment, and some personality disorders such as avoidant, dependent, narcissistic, histrionic, and obsessive compulsive disorder. Let us understand the concept of evaluation in Gestalt therapy. Gestalt counseling has its own unique contributions, which stresses an individual's inherent wholeness and capacity for self-awareness. The other contributions include application of dialogue, importance of therapy process, confrontation of unfinished business with dream work, and here and now experiencing of the client. Gestalt interventions give less importance to cognitive factors. A poorly trained therapist or who lacks skill, knowledge, training, experience, and judgment may misinterpret the therapeutic procedures. The here and now orientation could limit the freedom of a counselor to find out the history of an issue or problem. The therapy is inappropriate to clients in situations where people need urgent help. Gestalt psychology is grounded on existential principles, which explains that the whole is important than the summation of its parts. An individual needs to be understood based on the figure, ground perception, which means the person within the environment. The basic concepts of Gestalt therapy are homeostasis, awareness, unfinished business, and responsibility, top dog versus underdog, and here and now. The major objective is integration of person by increasing the awareness through the therapy sessions. Either dialogic and therapeutic relationship need to be established for a therapeutic change in the client. The process has three stage sequences such as discovery, accommodation, and assimilation. The techniques of the therapy include empty chair dialogue, I take responsibility, reversal, rehearsal, dream work, and nonverbal language. The therapy can be applied to diverse client populations. The cognitive factors have least importance in Gestalt counseling, but it emphasizes the importance of an individual's wholeness and capacity for awareness.